Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to be looking at the CWL Esports match between Unfair Warfare and the Killzone. Right, first attack coming in from the Killzone. Funk, FNK. The Warden Walk coming down from 3 o'clock. King coming down from about 5. Into a King trade-off here. Baby Dragon and Witch to help with the funneling. A Wizard to help with the funneling. And to rage up the Grand Warden here. Never nice to burn a rage on your Grand Warden walk. Yetis are coming down. And a Wall Wrecker. Eagle hits lock on. Single target Inferno. Locking into one of the Yetis. What is that Wall Wrecker doing? Wow. What happened there? Just decided to do a left turn. So all the Yetis now have just come straight out the base. He's managed to get his Grand Warden internal tome off, but what on earth has happened there? I mean, this has gone south really quick. Managed to get the two. Well, he's got the star for the Town Hall, so it's just now what it's about is ensuring you get the two star, I guess. Queen's still got her ability. It's just gone off to take out the single target Inferno. Got the Scattershot and the Grand Warden statue locking on, so she's going to go down. Ice Block Golems come down the side here. Yeti Mites have been taken out before they can do any damage. That has gone south really, really quick. I just can't believe what that Wall Wrecker done. I've got to watch that again. That is crazy. That is over. 67%, 68%. Good try. Nice try. So, Wall Wrecker's locking on, and then, but it looked like it'd gone to the wall and then just went sideways. What's he doing? What is it doing? I mean, that is where it all went wrong. Unbelievable. I've never seen a Wall Wrecker AI do something like that. Is it something to do with the Eagle Block? Does it happen? I don't know. That's crazy. Next attack coming here by Skiff on Basil. Going in with a Yeti Smash with a Quad Quake. We could pay from the Quake there. Warden Walk up at 1 o'clock. Heckers are coming down to take out this Tesla farm. We'll jump in through there, take out the Town Hall on the way through. Just gotta hope that he's formed enough of the funnel. You don't want Yetis coming off this way here. Yetis will come down. Doing the King Dreidel. We're starting to work in towards that jump, and everything's taking it, which is good. Go on, take it. Town Hall. Oh, Lava Hound's been popped from the enemy CC. Town Hall still beating down on them. Eternal Tome finally goes off. Doesn't look like much of the kill squad has made that. Town Hall still will not go down. Royal Champion being forced to come in. A load of Yetis have split. and they're working their way around outside the base. Queen managed to get the single target down, keeping it off of the Royal Champion. Now Yeti's around the outside of the base. How much can that Royal Champion do? Ability's popped. What can we get on that Inferno? Not enough. Not enough. We've got some wizards for cleanup, which can probably help out. That mortar's going to do a bit of damage up there. And then the Yeti's just going to walk around the outside. Getting percent. It's not going to be a triple. It's all about percent. Already up now on percent, 70%. Should get into the mid 80s. Yep, 83, 85, mid 80s. Can't say closer than that. I have not seen. I know these are replays, guys. I haven't watched any of them, so I'm watching them live with you. So, as I say, it was a nice try, but it just took forever for that town hall to go down. Okay, Skiff taking a defense now. Running a ring base. Oh, Tesla farms coming out. That's not going to be useful. It needs to take out some of these Teslas. Take the damage off. Baby Dragon to try and help. Again, has to burn a rage on the Warden Walk. It's not ideal that. But sometimes you've got to do what you got to do. Right, we got a Pekka working from up top. King's been dropped, along with a wizard. So you can see his plan. I'm not sure he really needed the jump there. Could have wall broken. Saved himself two spells. Down comes the Yetis and the Bowlers. Queen's there as well. Rage come down. Got a blimp. He's going to try and get that all the way to the town hall with any luck. Eternal Tome to make sure that blimp does get all the way there. Rage for the center to make sure the town hall goes down. Which it does. Now it's just a case of seeing what's happening there. There's an enemy ice golem there, which was slowing everything down. Right. Got another jump. The racer wants to take down that multi-target inferno. Queen still has ability. RC still has ability. But no more spells. So now it's just a case of, can those healers keep those troops alive? It's all looking okay so far. One wizard to help with clean up down the bottom, but that's not going to be enough. Where are those Yetis going? Right, RC is down. Queen still has ability. There's not a huge amount that can really hurt this. The Queen is beating on the wall. That's not ideal. Would want her to come in and take out this Inferno Tower and the enemy King. She's just going into cleanup now. So yeah, that is not going to be enough. If the Queen carried on working her way around, may have been good enough. ...96%, and that is it. That is all she wrote. 96%, Jason. Nice try. Really good try. Zoom coming in on Jason now. We've got a Electroloon from 9 o'clock. He's coming in with the Yetis. Seems to be a bit of a trend here for this war so far. Pekka's coming down to help with the funnel. Quadquake getting massive value out of the Quadquake there. Has activated the Town Hall, so that will need to be looked at. And again, nicely worked funnel there. Yeti's come down. Healer's come down, so does King, so does the Queen. enemy CC, which is a ton of archers and some ice golems. Eagle locking on. RC is going to try and take out that single target Inferno, which she will do thanks to the Grand Warden's Eternal Time. Ice Golem's really slowing everything down there. Rage for the Town Hall, so the Yetis can hopefully go away from the blast. Some of them have. There's a jump there, which I don't think anything's going to take. No, they're all going to try and beat outside now. I think the Yetis really know where they're going. You could see the plan there. He wanted to get the Yetis to go in and take out that single target, and then, to say it, it would just be a time, you know, time thing after that. I think there wouldn't be enough on the base to really take everything down. But now those Yetis and everything are working down the south side of the base. Not quite enough on it. They're going to beat through that wall. So we'll just fast forward this a little bit. 10 attacks to get through. Queen still has ability. It's definitely a percentage game. But again, we've got another Queen beating on that wall. Into the 70s. Going quite nicely so far. So it's not a triple, but percentage is key. Queen has popped her ability, and that is all she wrote there. So timeout, 83%. Nice try, Zoom. Really good hit. As I say, I think the plan was there. If the Yetis had all taken the jump, it could have been a different story. So really nice try. Surge taking on Risty here. So Coco Loon for the Queen Walk. Pulls a Tessa farm. Take out the enemy king. Couple of loons there just to help with that side of the Tesla farm. Was going to use a minion to help with the funnel, but Tesla farm had other ideas. King down from 3 o'clock. Queen pulls a tornado trap. A load of ground skellies come up. Rage comes down again. Freeze for the town hall, which is going to go down. Wall break into this compartment here, so the queen can go in and get a bit more value. So out comes 3 ice golems, which is always a nuisance. Scat shot is beaten down on the queen here, so no more rages to keep her alive. Might have to burn a freeze on that. Queen didn't get her ability off. Scattershot took it down. That has not ended well. So siege barracks from the top. Miners are now going to try and work in through the base. Hogs as well. Freezing on the scattershot. Grand Warden Eternal Time. There is a ton of ground skellies that are coming out of Risty's base here. Miner's going to take down that second set of shot. We've got to get that eagle down. Now that is key. He does have heals to use. RC's working through. Enemy queen and enemy RC. No more spells. Hogs are working through. How many can... What can those hogs do? What can that hogs and RC do? The answer is not quite enough. There's miners working on that Inferno. Got wizards up top. But that is it. That's all we have. That's a nice defense there, Risty. As I say, Queen missing that ability. Certainly was an issue. Splash damage. Auto ability does not go off if splash damage is on you and you're at low health. It will just miss it completely. So you've got to remember that, guys. You know, if you've got splash damage on you, whether it's a scat shot or a mortar, something like that, you have to make sure that you pop your queen ability to make sure that you get it off and get some damage done. Right. For Plantia. Sorry if that's not your name, mate. I really do apologise. You'll have to tell me in voice how you wanted me to pronounce that for Plantia. I'm not sure. Anyway, coming in with a Yeti blimp. Lands a target there. It's going to take out the single target. Pull the enemy CZ. And clear that entire compartment. So that is a really, really nice drop there. Use a freeze just to ensure it got there. Queen walk coming down from the 7 o'clock area. Ice golems in the CC are now going to start working their way towards the queen. The bowler bounce just to help with the funnel, so you can see what's trying to happen here. Got another hybrid attack. Test wall breaker comes down. The rage. Now, wall breakers go in. And queen can go in as well. So, I'm going to take out the town hall. Activated the eagle artillery. King coming up from top. Again, and I would imagine he's trying to get the hybrid to work its way through the center of the base here, which he has done. Miners go down. Hogs are coming down now. RC for that Tesla. Well, everything's got to start working in now. Warden seems to be locked on the king. That's not ideal. Hogs have all gone ahead. Got to get that eagle target. Eagle down. Eagle. Eternal Tome goes off. Everything is in within the Eternal Tome. That looks a little bit worrying for a second there. So, heal down in that area. Royal Champion abilities go off. A couple of... I've just got a single target Inferno. And the enemy... the enemy RC. A few miners up top working down. Those miners are getting roasted now. One by one being picked off. Queen's still going. Can the queen reach that single target? No, she can't. Manages to get the royal champion down, but that is it. And he's got his lonely goblin. Trying to claim some percentage, but 91%. Really nice try. Top attacking here, just not quite locking on. Right, Basel coming in. I have seen this base before. And how it can be taken down. So, Royal Champion and Ice Golem up top. Unfortunately, the single target has gone straight onto the Royal Champion, not the Ice Golem, so it has to burn a freeze. Ability goes off. Gets down the first single target. Right. What next? There's a wizard up top. I'm not really sure what his plan is. He's got yetis and bowlers. Queen walk from up top. There's a jump spell. All the healers are coming down. So king is now just working as a funnel. Could carry on walking, you know. A load of loons get dropped. So everything's working down that channel, which is not too bad. Eternal Tome. trying to keep everything alive here. Jump spell into that side of the base. It's got the blimp. So the loom was obviously there just to take a few bits out. Black bomb. Does lock down. Is he going to take down... Hasn't got a rage on that. Wouldn't it be enough to take down Town Hall? Just about. Not a huge amount working through the middle now. There's Yetis with no Yeti mites, empty baskets. Queen does have the ability. She's going to have to pop. Freezes the Inferno Tower. Ability goes off. Cannons are locked onto those healed Yetis, so a wizard could come down and pick off some of those cannons. Queen's got to beat on a wall. Don't think those. No, that's it. Only one healer wasn't enough to keep her going. Healers are working out again. Another really close attack. Just fine margins, guys. Fine margins at this elite stage. Not sure I can put that quite down to a time fail. But quite possibly. Right, Mini Sick. Coming in against Kid Hades. Some Chinese writing. Right. Couple of Cocoa Loons with a blimp. I guess looking to take down a single target and hopefully that scattershot. Ice Golems come out. Another hybrid attack here, guys. Scattershot remains up. Loons and Baby Dragon coming down with the Queen Walk. Two Ice Golems survive the blimp. Got an Ice Tower locked onto one of the healers there. That's frustrating. Wizard's got to try and... No, Wizard's got distracted on the Town Hall. On the enemy clan castle. I'm hoping that Queen... Yeah, the Queen's going to work in now. No, Queen's working out. Queen is working... Oh, no. Cool, I'll tell you what, this Queen's giving me the dizzy now. Yep, so Queen's going to work in. The aim is to try and get the Town Hall, obviously. Sweeper goes down. Healers are in range of the Giga Inferno. Managed to stay up nicely. Queen goes down again. I don't know what happened there. Did the ability go off? I think I missed it. Yeah, Hybrid's coming down now from 6. They're trying to, again, help with the funnel up top here with the King, but those Tester Farms and everything got in the way. Heels go down. Grand Warden's got to catch up. Those hogs are way, way ahead. Ah, miners are going back. Scattershot. Lacing down on them. Eternal Tome is off. Not quite enough. Got a loon for that mortar. Secures the 2-star. Let's say I just couldn't quite see what happened with that. With that queen. Did the ability go off? Maybe it was the mortar shot. Here, Inferno, you can see the healers are just going down. They do all survive. So, loads of... Oh, it's the blast. It's the blast from the Town Hall. That's what took it down before the ability went off. Splash damage, guys. It's a real thing. Right, so Hades coming in with the revenge attack. Coco Loon pulls a black mine. Baby Dragon pulls a red mine. Down comes the Queen. Let's have Wall Breakers. Some of the new super troops. So he's going to try and charge in here. Risking a one-hit format to try and come away from the other side of the town hall. So, rage and freeze on that Inferno. So I have to burn another freeze unless the ability wants to, unless he wants the ability to go off. King's coming down from 12 o'clock. Freeze goes down on that Inferno. Queen's going to be able to take that one out. Super Troop! Super Troop! Burst Wall break in. Okay, gotta take out that enemy queen. Ability goes off. Gonna take on quite a bit there. Down comes the miners and hogs, but they it does have the enemy CC up there. So we've got witch and double ice column. Early eternal time. Try and protect everything and keep it going through. Heal goes down. Another heal. Town hall is activated. It's got siege barracks come down from about 10 o'clock there, just help them keep everything inside. This is looking a bit crazy. The RC should have it, especially with ability gone off, but the RC does take the blast. Got siege barracks hulks coming out there. I'm still working through. Don't think this is enough, guys. I'm not sure he's quite got enough on it. Enemy royal champion doing work. Not quite enough. Nice try. Heart must have been in his mouth at some point there. I was nervous just watching that. So, right. Killzone have 10 stars. They do have us on present. Last attack. Right, Risty coming in. Bleeding from the front. It's coming in with the Yeti Smash. It's got a couple of peckers. The suspense is killing me. Right, pecker comes down first. And then down comes the siege barracks really early. Pecker up from 9 o'clock as well. Mortar is locking onto that siege barracks. It's not ideal. Jump goes down. So you can see the plan here. He's just going to try and charge straight through the middle of the base. All the heroes go down. All the Yetis and the healers. Very, very quick deployment there. And a rage. Eternal Tome. Go for it. Now. Perfect. Perfect timing on the Eternal Tome there. Out comes the enemy CC, which is a ton of archers and a couple of ice golems. Not ideal for a Yeti Smash, those ice golems. Everything is still working through quite nicely. He's jumping through the base beautifully, taking three jumps. Enemy Queen's locking on. She goes down. Eagle goes down. This is looking pretty tidy. Got a rage for everything to work in. Got to take out that single and that multi. Maybe King's in there as well. Royal Champion doesn't have quite enough to take down the single. Yeti Mites look like they're doing a lot of work on that Inferno. Queen still has ability up top. Can she get that? She can't reach it, so she's going to have to continue working. There are healers working on these Yetis through the middle here. This is looking pretty good. We've got wizards on cleanup. We've got a loon that's doing a little bit of work on that cannon. The jump is still there. Have we got this? We've only got this. The triple from the main man. Oh, that is absolutely clutch. I mean, I've never seen, that was cool. Whew. Triple jump through the base, absolutely wrecked. That single target Inferno looked like it was going to do the work, but my God. Unbelievable from the main man, and that's enough, 11 to 10. As I say, I mean, only the one triple in it, but they had us on percentage. They had 85.8%. So we needed that triple. What a win. Right, guys, that's the recap for that one done. 10 attacks for the CWL Esports League, the top one. And our guys there pulling out the win against Killzone. So, and so if you like this video, leave me a comment. Let me know. If you want to see anything else on the channel, please do let me know. It's where I get most of my ideas from. If you like the video, please smash that like button. Give some hype out for Unfair Warfare there. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next video.